Hi friends, in this video we will discuss about overtaking side distance. If all the vehicles travel along a road at the design speed, then theoretically there should be no need for any overtaking. In fact, all vehicles do not move at the design speed, as each vehicle driver is free to travel at lower speeds. And this is particularly true under mixed traffic conditions. In such circumstances, it is necessary for fast-moving vehicles to overtake or pass the slow-moving vehicles. Therefore, efforts should be made to provide adequate side distance along the road alignment to enable vehicle traveling at design speed to safely overtake slow-moving vehicles. Now, we will see the formula for overtaking side distance. Vehicle A traveling at the design speed V km per hour decides to overtake another slower vehicle B moving at a speed VB km per hour. The vehicle A has to accelerate, shift to the adjacent right side lane, complete the overtaking maneuver and return to the left lane before the oncoming vehicle C approaches the overtaking stretch. The overtaking side distance is divided into three parts, that is D1, D2, D3. D1 is the distance traveled by overtaking vehicle A during the reaction time T of the driver from the position A1 to A2 before starting to overtake the slow vehicle B, that is D1 is A1 to A2, then D1 will be VB into T. T is the reaction time and D2 is the distance travel from position A2 to A3. And this is T2. Vehicle A during the actual overtaking operation during T seconds from position A2 to A3. Then D2 is equal to the spacing distance from A2 to B1 is S, and B1 to B2 is B, and the spacing distance between B2 to A3 is S. Then D2 is equal to B plus 2S, that is VB into T plus 2S, where S is the spacing between these vehicles. S is equal to 0.7 VB plus 6. This is empirical formula. T is time taken during the overtaking operation. T is equal to square root of 4s by A. A is for acceleration of a vehicle. And D3 is the distance from positions C1 to C2. When D3 is the distance traveled by oncoming vehicle C during the actual overtaking operation of A during T seconds from position C1 to C2, where D3 is equal to V into T. Thus, on a two-lane road with two-way traffic, the overtaking side distance is equal to D1 plus D2 plus D3 in meters, and for overtaking side distance on one-way traffic road is equal to D1 plus D2 in meters. Thank you, friends. Hope you like this video.